It's all right.
Too far out. You okay? Yeah, boy. IRL food. Too far out. You okay?
The first tip, have a proper warm-up. Your dynamic warm-up is extremely important for the event. This should include things like high knee drills, butt kicks, skipping variations, as well as walking while you stretch. Also warming up your shoulders, your wrists, and your hips and back are extremely important. The second part of the warm-up includes sprint form drills with the pole or pole runs. Similar to the dynamic warm-up, you want to do things like butt kickers, high knees, skipping variations, all while you're holding the pole. This helps get you used to planting the pole. Even if it's been just a couple days since your last vault workout, it gets your body ready to plant the pole. The second tip I want to give you, including straight pole drills as a part of your pole vault workout. This means you've already done your dynamic warm-up. You've already done your sprint form drills with the pole and maybe a pole run or two. You're now on the pole vault runway. You're doing straight pole drills. These straight pole drills allow you to focus on mental cues and technical cues in the event without putting so much impact and stress on your body. The third tip, incorporate bent pole drills into your pole vault workouts. So now you've warmed up on the track with your dynamic warm-up, your sprint form drills with the pole. You've done straight pole drills. Now you're working on bent pole drills. Things like the running plank drill, the half drill, the three-quarter drill. If you don't know what these drills are, look in the description below or any other bent pole drills on a smaller pole, gripping low, that's going to allow you to focus on mental and physical cues within the event. The fourth tip I want to give you, whenever you start going at a bungee, which should be after all of the warming up, the straight pole drills, the bent pole drills, start the bungee low. You want to start the bungee about a foot and a half to 2 feet below your personal best. This is going to allow you to have a bungee height that you can't just kind of flop over, but still allows you to reach and focus on those technical cues. You want to have consistency over bungees at this height, which should be around your opening height at a competition. You do not want to develop no hiding or other bad habits within the event. So starting at a bungee lower that you're comfortable with and forming technical consistency at that bungee is extremely important. Tip number five, probably the most important tip of them all. Start small and work your way up. This means bungee height. This means approach length. This means pole size and grip. You should never start a workout, even if you feel like you had a good workout on the track. You should never start your workout going back to full approach, gripping high, on your biggest pole. That video at the beginning where I actually broke two vertebrae on my back, that was due to me not listening to my dad, who's my coach, going back to the end of the runway and grabbing one of the biggest poles in my bag, thinking I had a proper warm-up, gripping pretty high on the pole, and basically not moving the pole through enough and landing in the box. That was 100% my fault. How that could have been prevented? Gripping about 6 to 9 inches lower, starting on a pole 10 or 15 pounds softer, maybe even doing some straight pole or bent pole drills at the beginning of that workout would have gotten my body a little bit more used to bending the pole and landing in the pit. That was literally one of my first faults of the workout and was a 12-week mistake on my part. Always start small and work your way up. One example, my vaulters typically vault around 14 feet at the high school I coach at. We start on 13 or 13.6 poles at the beginning of our workouts, and they end on 14 or 14.6 poles at the end of their workouts at this point in their pole vault career. What's important to understand about that is they all want to start on the 14 or 14-6 poles that are way above their body weight. But it's important that they get used to bending the pole properly, doing the proper form, so by the end of the workout, they can have success at the bungee heights that they want to have success at.
Say it to the camera.
Yeah!
Yeah! Follow WinderAthletics.com.
You're the only one with the height?
What's that website you always go to?
WinderAthletics.com.
Yeah, that's the one.